Hi, ladies. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Zanny B. Davis. And on this channel, I speak about hypnobirthing and how to live your best life as well. Okay. Those of you who are not following me on social media, I'm at Zanny B. Davis as well, where I share every single day hypnobirthing tips as well as just life tips in general. I'm a huge fan of helping women to practice self-care and prioritizing it as well, so that they can have their best life and feel great about their lives and be happy. And I like to say that hypnobirthing is the biggest self-care tool that you can use as a mother, and so our mom-to-be. And so that is why I'm so passionate about it as well. So today's topic is about overcoming your fears and how to use your why to do it, and using it with hypnobirthing as well. So this is what I'm speaking about on the blog this week as well. So if you prefer to read it, you can head over to the blog. I'll put the link in the bottom as well. I'm just trying to get this light out of the back so it doesn't look a bit weird. Anyway, so overcoming your fears, especially your pregnancy fears, what does that look like? Now, when you get pregnant, and those of you who are pregnant now, or if you're planning to get pregnant, I will let you know, your fears are multiplied like 1,000%, honestly. It's because obviously it's a new journey, it's the unknown. And added to that is a new person, a whole new person you're bringing into the world, and you are responsible for that person. So it's only obvious you're going to have fears. No well-planned mother can ever tell me that she doesn't have any fears. Whether you were planning for this baby for years, whether it's happened unexpectedly, whatever it may be, you're going to have some fears. Firstly, because we are human and we've had life a certain way, and we're always a bit wary about change, and it's a huge change in our lives. Secondly, it's a big responsibility. And thirdly, you are the mother, you're carrying a baby, your life is going to change drastically. So the fears are only common. It could be fears from small as I don't like the hospital, or I'm scared about the hospital, fear about tearing, which can happen. Obviously, a baby is coming through that whole layer, even though it accommodates and expands wonderfully. Things can happen. And it could be even bigger fears as to, can I really be a good mom? How is my life going to change? Am I going to have time for myself anymore? You know, what about self-care? Am I going to be able to relax? These are all rational fears that we have during our pregnancy. And I want to just let you know, it's normal. And the best thing that you can do is acknowledge these fears, write them out, say them out loud, and actually confront them. Because the thing is, when you have fears, as in everything in life, and you suppress them, and you try to wash them away, and you try to rationalize it, and be like, oh, it's okay, blah, 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 you are not facing it, you're not confronting it, and therefore it has that power over you to have this huge looming presence when it doesn't have to be. So just like everything when they say about secrets, when you hide them under the carpet, you need to be able to bring these fears out to the open, face them, let them know, you know what, I see you. I understand that you're there because you're there obviously to protect me, but it's not so. And so we can combat that. And my idea of combating it is using your why. And this is my own remedy, my own strategy. So I like to think back, like, why am I doing this? For example, why am I pregnant? Obviously, your answer may be because I want to have a baby. Simple as that. Obviously, that's if you were trying for a baby. If you weren't trying, then why am I pregnant? Then you might be like, well, I got caught. I got pregnant, right? Whatever your why may be, yes, that may be why you got pregnant, or how, actually that would have been how, but what about your why? What about why you're having this baby? Why did you choose to have the baby, right? And let that drive home these fears. So you could say, for example, I'm having this baby because I want to have a baby, and my husband and I have been trying for like a year. You could just simply say, you know, I'm scared obviously that my life is going to change drastically, but that's okay because my husband and I, we've been wanting a baby for a very long time, and so we're going to change this fear now into an affirmation and make it very, very positive, right? Yes, even though I have this fear, it's only normal, but I'm going to put strategies in place. For example, probably when my husband comes home on afternoons after work, I will let him have an hour with the baby while I go and have a long bath, while I go and read, put my foot up, watch a bit of TV, have some me time, right? That's a strategy that you could put in place to combat that fear that you have. And you will feel so much better because now you have something, you are doing something, you're taking the responsibility off of like this unknown, and you're making it into something that you have control over. And I love that. And that was one of the things that my husband and I did that I absolutely loved as well. That I just said, like, I was a bit worried, obviously, that, you know, baby's gonna overtake my entire life, which they do, morning to evening, you're home with the baby. But I love the fact that my husband would come home, and after dinner, I will let him have the baby for a few minutes or even like an hour or two. Sometimes they fall asleep when I'm upstairs. And I just take the time to, for me, whether I take a nap, whether I read, watch a show, take a bath, whatever. And it was just such a good time in the day. So even though I'll be stressed in the morning or during the day, I always have that hour or two to look forward to in the afternoon. And it made everything so much better, right? So that's something that you can absolutely do as well. So this is what I want to explain to you. Like, your fears are going to be normal, but it's absolutely essential that you look at your why, because that's your driver. That's going to help you to push and give you momentum to make a change and to do something about it. And therefore, you can do something firstly by just making some affirmations, making it very positive, making it like something that you want to come to fruition in the future. And you could go even further, as I said before, by setting up something in place, setting up a reactor for you to be able to change that fear or make it more of not as scary or not as really huge as you were thinking before. So that's something that you can absolutely do. So guys, that is what I really wanted to share with you today, because obviously I know that fears are really common, that fears are always going to be present, but the most important thing is absolutely bringing them to the front, confronting them, and putting them out there for all to see. And that's like everything in our lives as well. Okay, also I wanted to let you know that for the month of March coming up, I have 3 spots opened up for my hypnobirthing coaching program. I am now a fully fledged hypnobirthing coach, and I have absolutely amazing clients that I've worked with. You can go over to my website, zannybdavis.com/lovenotes, where you can read about their testimonials and their own experience for birth when they worked with me. And and then you could see like what's possible for you as well if you really decide to put in the work and do the practice. And it's not even like huge work. The most important thing is like hypnobirthing is like a huge self-care technique for you, and it's not going to feel like if you're doing anything except just prioritizing yourself, your mind, your body, and your soul. And that's what we do during hypnobirthing. So yes, I have 3 spots only open up for the month of March for 3 lucky, or not even lucky, but amazing moms to be, to work along with me to be able to have the birth experience that you desire. You can obviously, your partners can be involved, because the most important, which I think, is you having that support that you need when you're having your baby. And a lot of partners want to be involved. They want to feel like they're part of the birth, which they should. And we're gonna obviously speak about ways in which you can have your partner help you out, and how it can be such a great team effort. So if you're interested in working with me for the month of March, I want to invite you to send me an email on the link below, and we can definitely get to it. And we could speak about it, obviously, and see if it's a great fit for you. Of course, it's hypnobirthing, so you've got to be pregnant. Any stage is quite fine, obviously, but the closer you get to your birth, it's going to be perfect. But even though you do it sooner, you're going to have more time to just implement the practices, and you're going to be able to be even more prepared for when that time comes as well, okay? So let me know what else videos you guys would like me to speak about when it comes to hypnobirthing, if there are topics that you want me to cover. I would love to hear that. I always do blogs every single week over on my blog, on my website, and I do videos here as well. And of course, I'm on social media every day, sharing more about my life, sharing about my journey, and of course helping you through your own pregnancy through hypnobirthing. Okay, so I will speak with you guys next week. As I said before, if you have any topic or question that you'd want me to share, definitely let me know. Go ahead and share this video with anybody that you know who's pregnant or is expecting or wanting to be pregnant, and if it can assist them more. Okay, so I will speak with you guys soon. Take care. Bye.